A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 26 July, on the front page you have Karnataka Speaker disqualifies three rebel Congress MLAs. So this is further development in the Karnataka political crisis. We already saw the Karnataka government of Congress JDS, the coalition government, fell after they moved the confidence motion. They could not prove their majority in the House. So there are these rebel MLAs from the ruling coalition. So the speaker has not decided on their resignation yet. So now you can see Karnataka speaker disqualifies three rebel Congress MLAs. You can see, and he has promised to take decision on the resignation of 13 other rebel MLAs in the next couple of days. Then this is RTI amendment bill passed in Rajya Sabha amid protests. So the RTI amendment bill, which is severely diluting the status of information commissioner and the Central Information Commission at both central and state level. So this has been opposed by opposition. It has not, the bill was not even put for public scrutiny and debate. It was not sent to parliamentary standing committee. And now the RTI amendment bill has been passed in Rajya Sabha as well. Then below you have 100 pending cases set up POSCO court. So POSCO court has to be set up, protection of children against sexual offences court. So Supreme Court has ordered courts to be set up within 60 days now. So, this is the direction of the Supreme Court. The special courts in districts have to be set up. In those districts that have over 100 cases of child abuse and sexual assault pending trial under the POSCO Act. Then below you have Election Commission sets up team to probe VVPAT mismatch in Lok Sabha elections. So of the 1.25 crore votes counted, 51 did not match, says the panel. So now an investigation team has been established to look into this matter by Election Commission. On page 2 you have Green Panel approves creation of reservoirs on Yamuna floodplains. So this is the National Green Tribunal which has approved a Delhi government's proposal to create water bodies and reservoirs on the Yamuna floodplains. So conservation projects to recharge groundwater would be undertaken. This will help tackle the water crisis in Delhi. On page 5 you have UP Assembly passes bill on private universities. So opposition protested against this Uttar Pradesh private universities bill, especially on the anti-national clause which is mentioned in the bill. It says that there are around 27 private universities in Uttar Pradesh, so they will be brought under one umbrella law, and there will be transparency on fees and admission process which will be ensured by the bill. And the bill says that the private universities should ensure that their campuses are not used for anti-national activities. On page 8 you have Go to Moon if you can't bear Jai Shri Ram, BJP leader tells Adul. So this is a comment by a BJP spokesperson B. Gopalakrishnan. He exhorted filmmaker Adul Gopalakrishnan to migrate to some other planet if he could not bear to hear chants of Jai Shri Ram. So this has resulted into a controversy now. On page 9 you have Arunachal Tiger Park faces a wage crisis. So it has done away with 53 casual employees. This is Namdafa Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. So it has discontinued services now. It's a 1895 square kilometer tiger reserve, and it now has only 113 casual employees. So they are inducted under the Project Tiger of National Tiger Conservation Authority. So this is the wage crisis of Namdafa Tiger Reserve. At least you should know where is it located. I know it's in Arunachal Pradesh. It said almost 80% of Namdafa is inaccessible and it is difficult for the staff to monitor the remaining areas of Tiger Reserve. The reduced staff strength, it is said, will make it harder for the employees. So a National Tiger Conservation Authority has to provide a fund for wages of the casual employees, which it has not provided. Then below you have GSLV Mk3 helps reduce orbit raising maneuvers. So GSLV Mk3 is a rocket which has been used to launch Chandrayaan-2, and it has placed Chandrayaan-2 at a 6000 km higher apogee. We had seen this. So this coverage on that. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the terrorist tag. So this is regarding the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, which is proposed to be amended. So the act says that individuals who are accused of such terror related charges can be designated as terrorists. They're accused, they're not convicted. So this raises serious constitutional questions and has the potential for misuse. So this is the editorial covering this issue. And second is Boris Days. So this is regarding Boris Johnson, who is Britain's new prime minister. So he should abjure his dangerous brinkmanship in seeing Brexit through. So he has said that he would go even without Brexit if no deal comes from European Union, no new deal by October 31. So no Brexit is not good for either Britain or European Union. So he is using such tactics, brinkmanship as it is called, and that is discussed in this editorial. The lead article, In White Nation Talk, The Voice of the Squad. So this talks about how the Democratic Party positions itself in the poll run-up, cuts to the very heart of its identity and America's future. So recently we had seen President Donald Trump speaking on this woman, Congresswoman, Democratic Congresswoman, the four Congresswomen of color, and asked them to go back to their country of their origin. So this is covering this issue. And this is the miniature of Trump's mediation claim. The minutiae. So this says that governments pursue their national interests single-mindedly without allowing sentiments to influence their judgment. So this article talks on why he would have made such a statement, and so what is the bottom line and how things go ahead. On op-ed page you have how to make surrogacy bill more inclusive. So this is a view counterview coverage because government has restricted surrogacy option to married couples only. So this you can see till before the bill as such, we have seen that foreign couples have come here and have got children through surrogacy in India. So the bill as such does not allow commercial surrogacy. It says surrogacy can be only through altruistic means without any monetary benefits expected, and by a relative. So this is altruistic surrogacy which is being spoken of, and it has stringent provisions: only related person, only relative of the intending couple, close relative of the intending couple can become a surrogate mother, and she should also be married and have a child of her own. The couple as such should be married who want a surrogate child, and they also should not have any surviving child, normal child. So there are such strict conditions. So this article covers that, a view counter view on the issue. And this is making national legislatures more gender balanced. So this talks of how quotas can ensure more number of women MPs. So and getting reservation for women in Lok Sabha, as many a time steps have been taken, but it has not been possible. The women representation in Lok Sabha is quite low, so even barely 24%. On page 12, you have Lok Sabha passes triple talaq bill after JDU box out. So opposition leaders call for scrutiny of the bill, but bill has passed without being sent to parliamentary standing committee too. And below you have companies bill introduced in Lok Sabha amid opposition hue and cry. So parties say that a law has been enacted in a hurry. And then below you have UP government issues orders to withdraw 22 more cases of Muzaffarnagar riots. So UP government has issued orders to withdraw these cases. The 2013 Muzaffarnagar riots, actually there are a number of cases of riots registered. It was a communal riot between Hindus and Muslims, and the Muslims have settled in refugee camps outside Muzaffarnagar. So there are many cases of riots registered. So the Uttar Pradesh government has withdrawn orders, has issued orders to withdraw these cases. It does not want to fight these cases in courts. So otherwise, in general, when there are any cases registered of such nature, then the government becomes
the petitioner as such. So the UP state government doesn't want to take forward these cases. So it has issued orders to withdraw 22 more cases. Already it has withdrawn cases earlier. So 70 cases have now been withdrawn so far out of 90 cases, in which reports have been sought. Then on page 13, you have this of move on from Trump controversy. So this Ministry of External Affairs saying that there are plenty of things on the plate to take the India-US relations forward. So opposition should not make UN cry on Trump's statement. Then this is 5G data localization to dominate BRICS meeting. So Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa form the BRICS grouping. It's a five-nation grouping. And at the BRICS meeting now, 5G data localization will be issues which will dominate. So digital economy and US opposition to telecom major Huawei are likely to be prominent issues here. On international page, you have Ukraine seizes Russian ship in Black Sea. So, crew were freed after Russia warned of consequences if any Russian citizens were taken hostage. So, this is now conflict between Ukraine and Russia, you know, spilling over in the region. So, this is Russian tanker which was seized by Ukraine for its alleged involvement in capture of three Ukrainian Navy vessels by Russia. So, we have already seen Russia-Ukraine crisis, you know. Russia has actually annexed Crimea from Ukraine in 2014. Then, below you have Paris records its hottest day as heatwave sears Europe. So, we have seen how climate change is taking its toll on European nations too. Temperatures rising and hot, dry air coming in from North Africa is said to be the cause for it. On business page, you have High Court order could dilute center's GST anti-profiteering efforts. So, the decision taken by Delhi High Court recently has the potential to undo the government's steps to provide GST anti-profiteering authority with greater powers to ensure no profiteering occurs. So, the High Court has provided relief to Reckitt Benckiser India Private Limited by ordering an interim stay on the notice issued by Director General of Anti-Profiteering Authority. So, it is seeking information on all products of the company, whereas the National Anti-Profiteering Authority has ordered an inquiry for only one product. So, the notice issued by Director General was on all products. So, this has been an interim order of Delhi High Court is to stay this notice. Then this is PMO asks Finance Ministry to study overseas bond issue. So concerns have been raised over its implications of overseas bonds. So Prime Minister's office has asked the Finance Ministry to conduct a detailed study on the issuance of overseas sovereign bonds. So the concerns have been raised by former RBI governors and deputy governors. You can see. So the Finance Ministry will look into the matter. Then on the last page you have, Earth is warming at faster pace than in last 2000 years. So this is a study in which researchers have used data compiled from nearly 700 temperature indicators. And they say world temperature rose faster in the late 20th century than in any other time in the last 2000 years. And then this is, flying inventor fails to cross English Channel. So this is Frankie Zapata floundered when he had to refuel his jetpack mid-sea. So this, you can see it's a flying experiment, a French inventor. He failed in his attempt to fly across the English Channel while standing on his jet-powered flyboard. But he said he'll try it again now. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, ashr.com.